In today's hydraulic and lube systems, technology is changing more and more to be compact, with higher efficiency and lighter weight. Where this can serve to help organizations carry more machines in their fleet and ultimately save space, there are some downfalls that come with the good. Some of these issues that arise with reducing size, raising efficiency, and decreasing weight include tighter tolerance hydraulic components that are more sensitive to contamination, less than ideal reservoir size and shape for fluid life and preservation, and hotter oil temperatures and higher running oil pressures within the system. These conditions can evolve into more unforgiving consequences such as premature component failure, poor and irregular hydraulic system response, foaming of the oil and pump cavitation, insufficient resonance time in the reservoir for the air to release and foam to collapse, and shortened fluid lifespan due to increased oxidation. Given the issues that modern hydraulic systems have to contest with, let's not add problems caused by unnecessary contamination to the list of problems as well. During today's video, we will be going over the importance of properly sizing a filtration solution to your machine's exact requirements. A proper solution will correspondingly help fix some of those negative situations we mentioned before. As we go through our comprehensive 7 steps to choosing the correct filtration solution, keep in mind all of the negative situations we mentioned before and how they are addressed with a simple yet highly efficient filtration solution from Schroeder Industries. Step 1 is to determine the operating pressures of the system you are applying the filtration solution to. While determining the system's pressure, you must keep in mind these 3 factors. The environment the system is going to be operating in, whether it's dirty, clean, outside, inside, and mobile, where the filtration solution will be installed, and the duty cycles the filtration will see. These are all important to note when finally picking a solution. Step 2 is to determine the flow rates within the system needing filtration. Questions you need to ask yourself are, what are the maximum and nominal flow rates that the system sees? And is there a type of surge or backflow present in my system? These questions will lead you to finding the correct element sizing and material needs. Step 3 is to figure out what your most valuable component is. What we mean by that is, what component in your system requires the lowest or cleanest ISO code reading? It never hurts to pick an ISO code that is lower than the smallest ISO code that you need. If you're unsure about what ISO code you need, think of components that are breaking down or wearing out the fastest. As a note, we have charts available for general component ISO code levels for just about any part you are looking for. The component OEMs will also list ISO code cleanliness recommendations in their own product catalogs if you are looking for a more precise code for your system. Step 4 is to use the ISO code you found in Step 3 and match it to a micron rating. Each ISO code has a specific micron-rated filter element you should use to best capture and retain the size contamination most prevalent in your system. Using this chart will guide you to choose the correct micron rating. If you're between ratings, remember you can always go to the lower ISO code. Step 5 is to recognize the fluid you are using. The type and viscosity of the fluid that runs in your system will help you determine the seal type, media type, and contamination type you are experiencing the most problems with. At Schroeder, we offer media solutions for mineral-based oils and fuel that remove solid contamination, water, and even electrostatic discharge. There is a filter for all. Step 6 is to determine your maximum operating temperature. Temperature will help you verify the use of the proper housing size and, more importantly, viscosity. Viscosity will affect the differential pressure and will need close attention. Knowing your working and cold start temperature is very important. Step 7 is to piece it all together. With all the information gathered from steps 1 to 6, you can calculate the overall system differential pressure. If all pieced together correctly, your solution should result in your clean element pressure drop being less than half of the overall bypass cracking pressure at normal operating temperature and flow. Remember to note the porting options you need for your specific system, and if you would like any contamination indicator options too. Today's compact and lightweight hydraulic systems sure do have a lot to worry about. it's best that operators and fleet owners do not let contamination be a problem. After following and implementing Schroeder's 7 steps to choosing the correct filtration solution, you will begin to see the results fairly quickly. Results such as seeing cleaner fluid, system components lasting longer, oil life extension, and reduction in maintenance intervals. These all should be positive effects of your new filtration solution. Thank you for tuning in today to learn about Schroeder's 7 steps to choosing the correct filtration solution. If you have any questions about the video you just watched, email us today at sisales@schroederindustries.com or visit us on the web at www.schroederindustries.com to find more information on our line of filters and how our partnership can be of an efficiency-improving benefit to your group.